Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's learn the lesson Going Places by A.R. Barton from class 12 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from classes 10, 11 and 12. Don't forget to press the notification button so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. So let's move on to the video now. About the author, A.R. Barton is a modern writer who lives in Zurich and writes in English. In the story Going Places, Barton explores the theme of adolescent fantasizing and hero worship. Introduction. The story revolves around a teenage girl, Sophie, her family and friends. She is a daydreamer who is always lost in her dreams of becoming rich and sophisticated, though in reality she is a worker at a biscuit factory. The story suddenly twists up when Sophie makes a wild imagination of meeting Danny Casey, a famous footballer. She also makes a story in front of her brother that Casey will come to meet her on a fixed day as per a promise he made to her. Here is a summary of the story. There is a conversation between two teenage girls, Sophie and Jansi. Sophie lives in a world of imagination, whereas Jansi is totally opposite to her. Sophie imagines of owning a boutique one day, a place where she can sell fashionable clothes. Jansi feels that it requires a lot of money to open up a boutique. She also tells her that it will take a long time to save that much amount. To this, Sophie replies that she will work as a manager, and when she will save enough money, then will work on opening up a boutique. She is interrupted by Jansi as she tells her that nobody will hire her straight up to the managerial post. Sophie changes her plan and decides to be a fashion icon like Mary Quant. She also adds that she will have the best boutique shop that no one has ever seen in the city. Jansi is a realistic person. She knows that in reality they are just workers at a biscuit factory. On hearing Sophie's thoughts, she becomes sad. When they reach Sophie Street, Jansi tries to explain the reality of their life. She tells her that they don't receive much at the factory where they work. She also tells her that her dad would not allow her to leave the job. Sophie, on the other hand, is still lost in her dreams. She says that she can also be an actress, as it would earn her a lot of money. She also wants to run a side business of boutique, as she thinks that actresses don't work full-time. When they reach home, Sophie enters into her house and turns the door. Jansi is left alone in the rain. Sophie is still murmuring the same sentence that if she will get money, she will buy a boutique. Someone in the house teases her that if she ever has money, she should buy a good house for the family. Sophie's father was eating a shepherd's pie. His face was unclean with dirt and sweat. Her younger brother Derek said to his father that Sophie thought that money grew on trees. He also felt that she was not realistic. Her mother, who was busy with work, took a deep breath. Sophie noticed her working in the kitchen. Her mother had stooping shoulders that were bent forward. She had tied an apron on her back, which was bent and not in the right shape. Maybe she looked so because the heavy burden of work on her. It was turning dark and the house was full of steam and the kitchen was messed up with litter. Sophie felt uncomfortable, so she went up to her brother Geoff. Geoff was in the next room repairing some part of his motorcycle. He was a trainee mechanic who had left school 3 years ago. He had to travel long distances in search of work. Sophie was sometimes doubtful about her brother, as he didn't speak much about his life. Therefore, she always imagined about the way of life her brother led. She was so jealous of his silence because she wanted to know about the places that he used to visit. She thought that they could be some distant places of the city or maybe some countryside. All these thoughts were so captivating because they were far away from her reach. Sophie imagined about her brother's personal life. She thought that her brother had never spoke about his life, but maybe he knew some non-native people who were very interesting. Though she knew that her brother didn't have many friends, still she felt that it was possible that he might have some special friends. So sometimes she wished she could become close to her brother so that he could take her out with him. She knew that her father would never allow her to do so. Even her brother considered her not big enough to go outside. But she was growing impatient and wanted to go outside, as she believed that she would be comfortable there just like in her own city. So she imagined herself riding with Geoff, he wearing a shiny black jacket and she wearing a beautiful yellow dress with a stole flying behind her as they would ride his motorcycle. She dreamt that people stood up to welcome her by clapping when she rode with her brother. Her brother looked annoyed at the oily part of the motorcycle that he was handling. He was trying to make it work, but all his attempts were wasted. Sophie said that she had met Danny Casey, a famous football player. Her brother suddenly looked at her and asked her where she met him. She said that she was in a gallery when she saw him. He didn't believe her and asked her if she told this to their father. She did not approve of her brother's question, as she wanted to say that he must know that he is the one with whom she shared her secrets. So she began her story that she was at the Royce's boutique and was looking for some dresses when somebody came and stood behind her. She turned and found him to be Danny Casey. Her brother asked her about his appearance. She told him that he had green-colored gentle eyes and was not tall as she had thought him to be. While both brother and sister were in their conversation, their father entered the room. He looked clean and shiny as he had taken a bath. He switched on his television and sat in front of his chair after shifting Derek's shoe from his chair to the sofa. As he sat in his chair, Geoff told him that Sophie had met Danny Casey. On hearing this, he turned towards Sophie. He looked at her scornfully because he couldn't believe her. Geoff clarified it to be true. The father told them that he once knew a man who had known Tom Finney a long time ago. Tom Finney was a legendary footballer. He took his name with great respect. Geoff agreed their father had told this earlier. They were discussing football players. Father said that he thought that one day Casey might become as good as Finney. Someone among Geoff and Sophie replied that Casey was better as he was very talented, but their father did not agree. He said that he was very young, and as there were so many diversions for a young footballer, he might work hard. Geoff did not agree and said that he was with the best team and the best player too. Meanwhile, Sophie told them that Casey was going to buy a new shop. Her father looked at her angrily and asked her as to from where she get to know this. He doubted it to be one of her imaginations. Her brother interrupted and said that she met him. Her father warned her that such things could lead her to trouble. She then tried to justify herself by saying that Geoff knew this and trusted her. Her father replied that he did not believe her, although he wanted to. Geoff's room was full of pictures of footballers. There was a picture of Casey also, who has been described as a young Irish man with exceptional qualities. Sophie told her brother another secret of her, but on a condition that he would not tell this to their dad. Her brother did not want to believe her, but listened to her because of her undue stress. She then told him that when she met him, it was she who started the conversation by asking him whether he was Danny Casey. She also asked for an autograph for little Derek, but as both of them didn't have any pen or paper, he promised to give it in their next meeting. Her brother did not believe this as he was doubtful of what she was saying. So he picked up his jacket and left. Sophie wondered if her brother did not care about his looks much though he should be doing so because he was tall and handsome. On Saturday, Sophie, her father and two brothers went to see the football match of their favorite team, United. It was a regular thing for them because they were all huge fans of football. Sophie, Derek and her father stayed near the goal and Geoff went up higher with his friends to see the match. Team United won the match with a score of 2-0. The second goal was made by Casey and he did it with such perfection. Everyone was happy. Sophie was so happy that she glowed and Geoff was so excited. Sophie's father went to the pub after the match and so she brought her brother Derek back home. Derek told his mother that this time Ireland would win the World Cup. Sophie was inquired by Jansi as to what was she telling everywhere. Sophie surprisingly asked her the reason for asking her this question. She then told her that her brother Geoff told Jansi's brother Frank that Sophie had met Danny Casey. Sophie got angry because she had never thought that her brother would disclose her secret. She was worried because Jansi had the habit of sharing secrets with the whole neighborhood, which she didn't want to happen. Sophie got angry with Geoff's behavior. Sophie explained to Jansi that this was a secret and she didn't want to share it because then people would line up outside their house and ask about this. Her dad would kill her on this. Jansi got surprised to hear this. She said that she thought that her father would be happy to hear this. But Sophie told her that it was not so and the continuous noise of the neighbors could disturb her mother too. She realized that Jansi was not aware of each and everything, so she felt happy that her brother did keep some part as a secret. She then told her that she had met him and asked for an autograph but couldn't get it because of lack of pen and paper. She even tells Jansi that her dad did not believe her. Jansi promised to keep her secret. After it was dark, Sophie went through a sheltered path along a waterway. It was far away from the noisy city. She used to play here as a child. She sat on a wooden bench which was under a long elm tree. According to her, it was the perfect place for lovers to meet. She sat there and started waiting for Casey. She got lost in her imagination of Casey coming to meet her. After a while, she realized that he was not coming and it was just her imagination. Many thoughts came to Sophie's mind. She waited for Danny to come, but he didn't come to meet her. She felt a deep pain inside her. She thought that people didn't believe her story. If Danny came, she could tell them that she was not lying. Again, she thought that it is not an easy thing to make everyone believe oneself. As so many thoughts were coming to her mind, she felt like many changes were taking place inside her. All this was very painful and she wanted to leave now. Sophie became sad. She felt it to be very tough to bear the burden that Danny didn't come to meet her. She had been waiting for him, though she knew that he would never come. She was also worried about how people would doubt her and disbelieve on what she said. She also thought that Geoff would beat her hard against the door on knowing that Danny didn't come to meet her. So she is quite sad now. As she was walking back to her home, she saw her father's bicycle in front of the pub. She felt happy that she would not have to face her father on reaching home. While Sophie was returning to her home, she passed through the Royce's boutique. She again imagined meeting Danny Casey. She again tried to initiate a talk with him by asking him if he was Danny Casey and also asked for an autograph. When she asked for an autograph, they both realized that none of them had a pen or a paper. She felt sad for her brothers. When Casey left, she kept standing there thinking of his sweet voice, green eyes, innocence and his geniuses. Then her imagination took her to the football match she had watched with her family last Saturday. She imagined of Danny Casey striking the goal in such a heroic way that she felt an explosion on the football ground. She felt so overjoyed with the winning of the United team and with the heroic performance of Danny Casey, her hero. Questions and answers. Question number 1. Sophie and Jhansi were classmates and friends. What were the differences between them that showed up in the story? Answer. Sophie and Jhansi were totally opposite to each other. Sophie was always lost in her dreams. She wanted to lead a life full of luxury and sophistication. She dreamt of owning a boutique, be like Mary Quant or an actress, and wanted to become rich and famous. On the other hand, Jhansi was a girl who had a realistic approach towards life. She knew that they came from a poor family and were working in a small factory. Therefore, she did not involve herself in daydreams like Sophie. Question number 2. How would you describe the character and temperament of Sophie's father? Answer. Sophie's father is a plump and aggressive person. Sophie fears his anger. He doesn't believe in the wild stories of his daughter, but as a caring father, he reminds her not to make such stories as this could lead her to trouble. He is a football fan because he visits the football ground with his kids every Saturday to watch his favorite team United play the match. He also wishes Danny Casey to become like Finney and enjoys the winning of his team by visiting the pub. Question number 3. Why did Sophie like her brother Geoff more than any other person? From her perspective, what did he symbolize? Answer. Geoff was an introvert type of person and he spoke less about himself. This made Sophie like him as she thought that he visited some secret places that were full of interesting people. So she tried to win his affection in order to get a chance to ride with him to that special place where she would visit by wearing a beautiful yellow dress. She also imagined of being welcomed by the crowd there. Sophie wanted to live that beautiful life which was full of colors and happiness that Geoff lived, but she could not. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. Do like, share and give your valuable comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. Thank you for watching.